Right, it's time for What's Good This Morning. We're going to take you to Southern California now, where a therapy program is helping senior citizens and maybe lessen feelings of loneliness as well. It's called kitten therapy. Who doesn't need kitten therapy? Sloan is over here. She can't contain herself. She's like, I can't. I can hear you right now. This therapy offers residents in senior living facilities the chance to snuggle with little kittens who are in foster care. Look at that picture of granddaddy. Joining us now is Nadia Aseguera from the ASPCA in Los Angeles. I'm getting tongue-tied because I'm looking at these pictures and I'm thinking about not only grandparents who I know, but people who were not able to see their grandparents over the past year. And you have little Luna in your lap too.
I do. She's having her breakfast right now, so don't mind her.
Well, I don't blame her at all. I'd be having my breakfast now, too, but I'm so excited to talk to you about this program. So how were senior citizens helped during this kitten therapy or through this kitten therapy?
Yeah, so, you know, at the height of the pandemic, they weren't really allowing visitors at senior citizen facilities, and our amazing foster, Lori, had been bringing her kittens in to work because they needed feedings throughout the day or socialization. So from there, kitten therapy was born. The kittens were able to be a companion for the residents. They pretty much just get to hold them. And there's nothing like holding a purring kitten.
Oh, yeah, the calm from that noise and from that purr.
Yes.
So this program was born during the height of the pandemic. Obviously, we've talked about this visitation being very restricted for those who are considered high risk, including seniors. So what was the response from families who knew that their family members were getting this type of therapy?
It was so rewarding for them to see their parents, their family, having somebody to spend time with. One of the residents' children mentioned that, you know, her mom didn't want to get out of bed, and she finally had something to look forward to by being able to spend time with kittens.
That's so sweet. And the kittens are helped as well, right? Because these are foster baby kittens. I love how I add the word baby into any animal story with a small animal. But the kittens were helped.
Yes. So between the ages of 2 and 7 weeks old, that's when kittens are little sponges and they can absorb, you know, new experiences, new sights and sounds. And so being held by multiple people and being exposed to this new environment is so beneficial for their socialization.
Versus being in a kennel, or what do you call it? A kitten kennel. Is it a kennel?
Yeah, you know, a kennel. So in a traditional shelter setting, they would be inside of a kennel. And, you know, that doesn't provide a lot of opportunities to climb and explore and, you know, get to be held by a lot of people.
Oh, I love that. I am sure you made so many people's day. And I hope this program continues because I think a lot of folks struggled with loneliness and just needed that personal touch and holding a little cat. I could just imagine how amazing that was. Thank you so much, Nadia, for sharing your story with us.
Of course. Thank you so much.
And I know, Sloan, you're beaming.
Yeah, how many are you adopting now?
Well, Luna looks like she needs a nice home. She takes the treats really well.
I've never seen an unhappy face holding a kitten.
Oh, I love it. Well, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.